This game is huge for both coaches and both programs. Nick and I expect one player to step up and provide us with one shining moment in today's third-round game between the Louisville Cardinals and the Baylor Bears.
It's showtime, baby. Let's skip the intros and get this one started.
You got it, partner. So without any further delay, let's get this one started. The Bears face a whale of an opponent tonight, Dick. How do they pull this one out?
The keys to the game are simple, Brad. First of all, don't give up any easy uncontested shots from behind the arc. Find those shooters. Next, take care of the basketball. Turnovers can really kill any rhythm offensively. Lastly, you can't win, baby, if you don't get the glass. You must rebound. Rebounding is the key.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court, and we'll see how this one plays out. Goes for the deep one. Bounces off. Number 10 receives the pass. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. The small forward handles the feed.
Look at that spacing.
The point guard handles the pass, and the ball goes out of bounds. He was applying great pressure defense. Went for the steal, but he wound up with a personal foul instead.
If you're going for the steal, you better get it. If not, this is exactly what happens.
Tries for two. Doesn't go. He keeps his dribble as they reset. He tries a three ball. Off the rim and no good. Number 10 receives the ball. He stays in control until they regroup the offense. Thinks about the shot. He shoots from the angle. Way off target. Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. He takes the shot.
He got off the nice shot off the dribble by running the defender into that solid screen.
They'll work it around the arc. Fakes the shot.
Blocked! What an unbelievable play, rotating over.
Knocks it down. Number 0 is animated and ready to go.
Well, he's had some success and he feels good. This kid's on an emotional high right now.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Can't get the shot to drop. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. And he'll kick it back outside. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure, just enough to force the steal.
He buries it. Now trying to feed the low block. Goes up for two. And he missed. Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
They go into the low block. And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
They work it around the perimeter. He uses the shot fake. Defender right up on the ball. 10 seconds to put up a shot. Gave it up. On the outside. On the dribble, gives it up. The ball goes out of play. Thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler.
Try to go inside.
And they do. They got Number 24 comes up with it. Down inside. He goes up strong, and that's going to be an offensive foul.
Oh, great call by the official. He beat him to the spot. That's essential defensively.
Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me?
Trying to feed the low block. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him.
That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
Looking for a good shot. Tries for two. Gets it to fall. Goes for the steal down low, and he didn't get it.
I tell you, he took a chance, and he lost, baby.
Got to get back on defense. And the ball goes out of play. Boy, assist-to-turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
The shot from the baseline. He puts in another score.
He can see the light, Brad, and it's hanging right over the goal.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
He hammers it home.
You can almost see that coming. They were a little bit lazy on a defensive end. Just too excited with that jam.
On the outside. Now they work it around the perimeter. The fans are really satisfied with what's taking place out there on the court. What a reaction.
What a reaction, Brad. The fans are loving it.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. He takes a three. Off the rim and no good. Moving it around the perimeter. They'll work it around the arc. Here's a spin down to the low block.
I think he's got a variety of moves. Use the sky hook, the jump hook, and now the spin move to the goal. Up and inside.
Gave it up.
He's a human eraser. I love shot blockers. They add such a dimension to your team.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
Stop and pop. Louisville have put together somewhat of a run here.
Maintaining it is the key, though. They've got to continue to make the hustle plays at both ends of the court.
Nick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
Let's see if they can get him the ball.
He puts it in with contact and all. Terrible execution on offense. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. When you're one of the top-ranked teams, you've got to bring your best every night. Teams are always looking to knock you off.
Hey, when you have a squad like this, Brad, you always have to bring your A game. Opponents will come after you with grit and boldness.
For the bucket, that was nice. That was like a NASCAR wreck and no whistle.
Wow, no call. You like that NASCAR. Hey, where's Mr. Petty?
Pass down low. There's a drop step. And, oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
Ooh.
He didn't have the good angle. They should have got it to him about a second earlier.
Goes up for two. Great shot. Start things up again. Big man spins down. He swatted everything out of the air,
including the other player.
Up and in. He shoots from the top of the circle, way off target.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Rejects it. On the dribble, gives it up. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, the leading team down here is very relaxed. I'm down by their bench, and the coaches are reminding them, despite the score, try and remain focused. Remember, it's the first half. Anything can happen, guys.
To get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
The ball goes out of bounds. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover there.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
Looking for a good shot. Jumped in front to take it away. From right in the circle, Dickie simply on fire.
Hey, call the fire department, baby. This one's burning up.
Let's it fly. The Cardinals have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Runs him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Gave it up for two and off the mark. Both teams looking to get things going here. Working it around the perimeter and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
And the ball goes out of bounds. The ball goes out of play. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Well, that's good defense, a steal on the inside.
Oh, what a way to force the turnover. Great anticipation by the post player.
They can't stop this guy, Dick.
Want to give him a try, Rod?
If only my knees weren't aching. They come with a double team to stop it.
Up it inside. Ooh, look at the shot block, but it got some contact. Nice hops.
Got the high pick. Ball down low, but it's kicked out. Pump fakes. Now the high screen for the bucket. He hits it.
Roll it back, fellas.
Yeah. stay with him defensively, and he's going to pick up the foul.
Oh, what a terrific job. Exploded in the basket. Poor job defensively letting him get the ball that deep.
There's a bad pass right to the defender.
Look at that spacing.
Dick, a great battle down in the low post, but I think the offense is gaining ground here.
Yeah, he's getting great inside position, has the great angle. He's got him set up perfectly for a basket. They got the 45-degree angle, which is essential in entering the ball to the post.
The Cardinals have got to continue to get him the ball.
And he's on fire.
Goes out of play. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover there.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
Number four, pump fakes. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
He knocks down another bucket there.
This kid's got skills, Brad.
Goes up for two.
He was unlucky on an inside shot off the screen.
He shoots from the elbow.
Nice job of using the screen to get open for that good shot.
Tries to get the D to bite. There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
Dick, he really seems to be getting great position down there in the low block.
Yeah, he really is gaining possession because he gets the good angle, and they also have the good entry from the wing.
Opportunity for two for one. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Puts it up. Off the rim and no good. He shoots from left of the circle. Way off target. Moving it around the perimeter. Jump hook from the low block.
That's a great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot.
He fires away. Off the rim and no good. Puts up a prayer. Off the mark. At the end of the first half, the Bears trail by one. If you missed the play of the half, here's another look. The ball to be taken away a lot in that first half, partner.
Not so much taken away, but given away. If you can't take care of the rock, you're not going to win many games.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
Thanks, Erin. With a little baby hook, off the rim and no good. On the outside. They're right on top of that pass. He fires from long range. He shows the sweet touch. Dumps it in. Tries for two. He's making just terrible choices shooting the ball.
He's got to settle down, man. Settle that cat down.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
He pushes it hard up the court. He pulls the trigger. The Cardinals have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
The power forward with the ball. A little bit of a collision there, but no foul called it.
I think good call by the official. Not blowing a whistle. I think it's an excellent call.
Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
Looking for a good shot. In the paint. For the bucket. He gets the bucket. Up fake.
Gotta think right now. Gotta focus defensively. One mistake on a double team and it's a 4-on-3.
And that usually means points.
Shooter spotting up on a 3.
Here's the offensive drop step and a low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
Rims out.
Nice fake.
There's a double team waiting there.
I tell you, good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk with their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake, and good footwork keeping his pivot foot down.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
The power forward takes the feed. He shoots from downtown. Dick, is the defense giving up?
No, I just think they're being overwhelmed by this offensive display.
Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper for two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Working it around the perimeter. For two. Off the rim and no good. Perfectly executed. The Bears are ahead by 5. On the dribble, gives it up.
Double team now, bad angle.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Jump hook from the low block.
I tell you, great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot. He may be in trouble here, Brad.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really good. A great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
He takes the shot from the baseline. Way off target. Vicky's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing. He's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
He looks for 3. He seems absolutely adverse to taking any good shots right now.
And with that, his teammates may be getting a little bit frustrated.
Down he goes, and no foul called either way.
Wow, no call. I can't believe that one.
The center takes the pass in the paint. Can't get the shot to drop.
Spacing. That was a high post screen. Goes to the lane.
The ball goes out of bounds. He shoots. Baylor are doing a nice job of pulling a solid run together.
Hey, they're really starting to clip on offense. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Goes up for 2.
Unbelievable. Look at that post position. He can't get a piece of that, baby.
try to come up with a steal, and they do. He hits the shot. He shoots from long range. Got it. The Cardinals trail by five. They work the perimeter. The small forward gets the ball. He launches the bomb. Rims out. The point guard takes the pass. There's a high screen.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, down here on the sidelines, there is such intensity from both benches. Both coaches are emphasizing shot selection and defensive stops. So important here in the second half.
Here's a double team.
Up and inside.
The offense gaining great post position down low.
Absolutely.
Rejected. Gave it up for the bucket. Off the rim and no good. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is. High post screen.
Looking for a good shot. Takes away the pass. Buries it. Working around the perimeter. Way out on top. Controlling the ball. Rejected out of there. On the dribble, gives it up.
Nice little jam right there. The one-hand jam and stuff. A little showtime, a little pizzazz. Get out the mustard. He's got hops like you, man. He got hops like you.
It is pretty similar.
Wow. I didn't realize my partner was a high riser.
Goes up for two, and he scores despite the hack. Gave it up. Fakes a jumper.
Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
Can't get the shot to go. He intercepts it. The point guard gets the pass. Picked out of the air. The fake.
Pressure that basketball. Help one another. Communicate.
Picks off the pass. Here's a flash from the high post.
The ball goes out of play.
Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover there.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
Fake. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
Nice defensive rebound.
They need to get out and run their lanes now.
On the outside. There's the pick. There's the roll. And the ball goes out of play. Number 50 draws the personal. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
This is the team's first trip to the free throw line.
Misses. Makes the second. Gives it up. There's the fake. They work it around the perimeter. 10 on the shot clock. The Bears will have their fans going silly if they can get a stop here. That's an ill-advised shot.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart. He got his jumper off by running that defender into the screen.
Well, Mr. Vitale, it looks like we're in for a great finish here.
Offensively, this is when it's extremely important to have the right people shooting the basketball at the right times.
Tries for two.
That's a good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk with their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake, and good footwork keeping his pivot foot down.
Gave it up. For the bucket.
Nice job to create the angle using the glass.
Working it around the perimeter. Shot rejected. Intercepted. Pass down low. There's a drop step and, oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
Picks off the lazy pass. Goes up for two. Louisville is showing a bit of a run here.
Things are going their way right now.
Picked off. On the dribble, gives it up. Looking for a good shot. For the deuce. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Top of the circle. Tickles the twine from downtown. Tries for two. And off the mark. Gets it to go. Gave it up. Gets it back out.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Great shot. Timeout. Let's check in with Aaron, who's standing by.
Well, at this point in the game, it's about being on the same page. Each player should know what the objective is for the upcoming possession. Offensively, you must know who the number one option is, while defensively, the type of defense you're going to play or whether to foul. Time is of the essence, Brad.
Thanks, Aaron. Back to the live action we go. It's a three-point deficit.
And that can change in a matter of seconds, baby. Hold on.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
He makes the shot.
5-point lead could go either way with this much time, Brad.
Oh, it certainly can, Dick. For two, he can't miss.
Finish up Max feeling it, Brad.
On the dribble, gives it up.
There's the trap.
The ball goes out of bounds. Mr. Vitale, how about that State Farm drive of the game?
Oh, Mr. Nestler, this one's superb. The ability to get close enough to the basket and then have the presence of mind to finish off the great play. Wow, what a play.
High post flasher is open. Steals the ball. Defense getting back to prevent an easy bucket. They work the perimeter. Wide open for the shot. Great defense.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He dials long distance. He gets the bucket to fall. See if they decided to go in another direction with things right here, Dick.
It wouldn't kill them to get a little diversity in their play right now.
On the outside, jumped in front to take it away. He takes a chance from half court. Misses on the three-point attempt. The temperature rises as this one goes to overtime.
Hey, even the fans are exhausted in here, Brad. Add extra time to the clock. At the end of regulation, these teams are all even.
NCAA tournament, and we are in overtime. Two evenly matched teams. They've played well throughout. Extra session coming up, Richard. You can't ask for more than this.
I tell you, we got two evenly matched clubs that have really responded. The PTPers are playing well. The stars, the coaches have their teams prepared. And it's all going to get down, I believe, to the free throw line at the end of this game.
Gave it up. This one might go down to the final buzzer.
In close games like this, Brad, offensive and defensive execution is very important.
Goes up for two. He shoots from left of the circle. Nope. Moving it around the perimeter. For the deuce. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all in them some.
He's obviously carrying his team, Brad. His teammates need to follow his lead and join in on the action.
Dick, he's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Working it around the perimeter. A high screen. Off the rim and no good. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Too much. That's a foul. Points off turnovers, Dick. A stat I know coaches pay a lot of attention to.
Hey, Brad, it sure is. You want to limit your opponent's number of points off turnovers. Ultimately, you want to nullify the easy basket.
Steals the pass. No foul on that interception.
No foul is right, Brad. That's Mr. Clean.
Oh. That'll do it for him.
His last foul of the night.
Oh, and this packed house is showing their appreciation for their team.
Well, there's euphoria out there. They're really excited. They're going bananas.
The Cardinals will step to the line for the first time.
Makes the foul shot. Hits the second shot. Tries for two. And in and out. He attempts the three. Rims out. Robs him of the ball. That was nice.
You better get rid of it, Brad.
He launches a three.
The Bears have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
Brad, he's on fire.
Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
Pushes it up. Jump hook from the low post.
I tell you, the jump hook, so effective, especially against a big post player. Very difficult to block that shot.
Timeout's called. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their teams down. With this much time remaining, they're stressing play smart basketball and take care of the ball.
Aaron's right about that. Action's ready to start again.
We've got ourselves a dandy here, folks.
The lead has been trimmed to four. In the paint. Executes the baby hook. Off the rim and no good. He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up and get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
Wanted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Steal. Turnover. Great job knocking the ball loose, then chasing it down. Let's it fly.
The more possessions you create, the better your chances.
Shot clock is dead. Well, Dick, it looks like they're going to spend a little bit of time fouling right here. Well, Dick, what's the backcourt situation looking like to you?
I tell you, Brad, guard play is such a huge part of the college game. Can't win without great guard play. Backcourt play dictates your team's success. Their play must be steady, consistent, controlling the tempo in a game, distributing the ball, scoring, and pressuring on a defensive end. They are all characteristics of having a solid tandem in a perimeter.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. And the clock stopped with a foul.
Brad, I think they'll continue to do so in an attempt to get back in the ballgame. They should look to foul the opponent's weakest free throw shooter.
And yet another foul. Number zero going to the line for the first time tonight. Everything looked good but the result.
ready for anything if you're the opposition.
It's down to a one-point game, Dick.
Yes, sir. This is where the big boys start to play, Brad.
For the bucket.
Perfectly executed. Get back to the action. For two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Maybe some game plan changes, Dick?
You never know what's coming, Brad.
But Dick, sometimes statistics lie, but in this tournament game, I don't think they do. The better team won, and they're going on.
Well, I tell you, they won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
Baylor just wanted it a little bit more in this game, and because of that, they're going to live to play another day, Dick.
Hey, they're on their way to the Elite Eight, Mr. Nessler, where they'll be joined by the seven best teams in the nation.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners, Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.